Today we're going to talk about extraction, and this is a lab technique you might use to purify a compound or to isolate a compound. And we're going to go through an animation that explores the process of extracting three times with ether, as you might do for a typical reaction workup. First, let's take a quick look at the equipment that we'll need to do a extraction. What we're using here is called a separatory funnel, or just a sep funnel for short. It has a stopper that fits on top. This might be a ground glass stopper or maybe a plastic one. If it's ground glass, you want to use the smallest amount of grease here as possible because we don't want to contaminate our solutions with that. But a lot of times we have a plastic one up here, and down at the bottom we have a stopcock. This is a valve that's going to allow the liquids to flow out or keep them in. This is all going to be supported by a ring stand and a support ring that allows the sep funnel to rest in it, and so we could take it in and take it out very easily without having to clamp it and unclamp it each time. Okay, inside the sep funnel we're going to have two layers. We're going to have an organic layer and an aqueous layer. And typically, as shown, the organic layer is going to be the upper layer because most organic solvents are less dense than water. The exception there is when we have organic solvents that are halogenated, like dichloromethane. That's going to be more dense than water, so we'll see it as the bottom layer. But typically, the organic layer is going to be our top layer, and whatever we have dissolved in the water is going to be described as our aqueous layer. So let's go ahead and get started with our animation. What we have here is a reaction mixture that a reaction has been quenched by adding water, so it's now aqueous. It's got a lot of components dissolved in it, and we're going to pour that in. Again, if you want to use a funnel up here to pour it more carefully, that's fine, so we don't get any spilling. And absolutely, you want to make sure that your stopcock is closed before you start adding liquids to it. And so, because sometimes we forget that, I think every chemist on the planet at one point has accidentally poured liquid into a sep funnel with an open stopcock. It's really good practice to have a flask down here, just in case if anything ever even drips. Sometimes your stopcock is loose and things might drip even though it's at the closed position, or of course if you accidentally had it open. So we're going to add our aqueous layer, and then we're going to take some pure ether and pour that in. Of course, that's going to create a top layer, and then we're going to mix the two layers. So we're going to put a stopper on top, and we're going to remove it from the support ring, and we're going to mix it gently at first and then more vigorously to achieve equilibrium. Okay, now as we did that, we noticed that you want to put your finger on the top of the stopper to make sure that the stopper doesn't come loose and nothing drips out of the stopper. It's held securely. And you also want to periodically open up the stopcock when the sep funnel is upside down. Open up the stopcock to release any built up pressure, any gases that may have formed. So as you're mixing, it kind of creates some gases, and especially when you're using something like sodium bicarbonate in your aqueous layer, that's most definitely going to generate some carbon dioxide and build up gases. So we want to vent it right away, and then periodically as we're shaking to make sure that we don't have any pressure that builds up. Okay, so we want to mix it thoroughly to achieve equilibrium, because during that process, the components that were dissolved in the aqueous layer, some of those are going to move to the organic layer, and we describe this process as partitioning. Now notice that not all of the organic soluble components have, you know, just raced over to the organic layer, only some of them. So this is described as the partition coefficient of that compound and how it likes to partition itself between an aqueous and organic layer. And that's what we're trying to achieve by mixing, is getting that equilibrium, where as much of the component is going to move to the organic layer as it wants to. Okay, so we're done with our first extraction. We're going to open up the stopcock with the stopper removed. We can drain the aqueous layer, and then we can drain the organic layer. You can drain it through the stopcock as shown, but there's going to be some water that's trapped in the stopcock, and so a better practice is you can just pour the organic layer out through the top of the sep funnel, and that way we're keeping our organic layer as water-free as possible. Notice too that we've labeled our flasks here. That's really good practice because it's very easy to kind of get mixed up on what's what, especially if both of these are, you know, clear colorless solutions. It's sometimes hard to remember which is which. Okay, so because the aqueous layer still contains some of our desired compound, we're going to do a second extraction. We're going to do multiple extractions. So we'll pour our aqueous layer back in to the SEP funnel. We're going to use another fresh portion of ether, and then we're going to mix these again. So add the stopper to the top, and while securing the stopper with our finger, we're going to mix it with periodic venting. Okay, now at this point, typically our organic and aqueous layers will nicely separate. And again, notice that most of the things here, another portion of our desired compound has moved over. But sometimes those two layers don't separate perfectly, and that's described as having an emulsion. If you notice that you are only getting one layer and not the two layers that you're expecting, there's a couple things that might have happened. One time is a very common mistake is if you had your aqueous layer in here and then you added more of an aqueous solution here, then of course you wouldn't get two layers. Or if you had your organic layer in here and that's when you added the fresh portion of ether, that's only going to give you one layer. So again, it's really important to keep track of what's what and make sure that's not why you got one layer. But if you've had two layers and then you mix them and after doing the extraction you still only have one layer, that's described as an emulsion. And so what we want to do is to break up that emulsion. A lot of times it's just being patient and letting it sit until they finally break up into two layers. Sometimes you can add a little bit of more organic, a little bit of more aqueous, so that might start that separation process. To break up an emulsion, you can also add a glass stir rod and stir things gently. Sometimes there's some fine particles in there or some kind of bubbles that you can break up. You can try adding some brine or some sodium chloride in there. So there's several strategies you can use to break up an emulsion if you have one. But once the two layers have clearly separated, then we can separate the two layers into two different flasks. Okay, so we're going to do a final third extraction, pouring the aqueous back in, another fresh portion of ether, trying to get this last little bit of our desired compound into the organic layer. So we're going to mix to achieve equilibrium, remove our stopper, and again, hopefully we're not forming an emulsion and these two layers separate nicely. We could drain our aqueous layer and then add the organic. Notice we're describing this now as our combined organic layers. So all of our organic extracts we're going to add back into the same flask so that we have all of our desired compounds here. Okay, now we have a few steps to before we could get to our isolated extracts. Very often we have some washing steps, and so what's in this organic layer might have some contaminants in there that we can remove by doing more extraction processes. So we could pour this organic layer back into the SEP funnel, and then maybe we can wash it with some portions of water, or maybe we could use a dilute acid. If there's any basic components in here, a dilute acid wash would remove those. If we had any acidic components in here, or residual acid, we could wash the organic layer with a dilute base, and that would turn that into a salt, and that salt, of course, would prefer to be in the aqueous layer. So we might want to have some washing steps in here, and then finally, we finish the extraction process by doing a drying process, and what that means is we want to remove any aqueous layer or water that is dissolved in the organic layer. So water does have some solubility in ether, and so we describe these combined organic layers as being wet with that dissolved water, so we treat it with a drying agent. We could wash it with some brine, some saturated sodium chloride. That would remove most of the water, but then to remove the trace amounts of water, what we do is we add a solid drying agent. So we just add, we put our solution in an Erlenmeyer flask as shown. We scoop in a small amount of solid drying agent and then swirl it around, and that's going to adsorb any dissolved water. And after we let that sit for a little bit, we can filter it off into a teared round bottom flask. So we're going to tear it, but that means we're going to pre-weigh it before we add the solution. And that way, after we remove the ether, we can right away just weigh the flask and we know how much compound we've isolated. So how do we remove the ether? We can maybe distill it, or if we have a rotovap, we can quickly remove the volatile solvent under reduced pressure, and we have our isolated product. Okay, so now we're ready to weigh it. We could analyze it with a variety of techniques, IR, NMR, TLC, so on, maybe GC, to see what components we have in there. And then if needed, we can purify it with other organic chemistry techniques like recrystallization or doing Cullen chromatography or so on. So hopefully you've learned something a little bit about the theory of extraction and some practical tips on how to carry out an extraction procedure in the lab. Thanks and good luck with your experiments.